So the correct diagnosis is epidermoid cyst. So let's look at some of the imaging features make epidermoid cyst see the best choice among the five possibilities here. First of all, you see expansion of the prepontine cistern as well as CPA, cerebral pontine angle cistern. So there's a mass effect against the brainstem as you can see right here. And on T2, it's extremely bright, just like CSF. On T1 post contrast, it does not enhance, just like CSF. However, on flare, it does not suppress like CSF. So the internal fluid content is not purely cystic or is not a CSF-like substance within. So when you think about CPA mass lesion in general, statistically speaking, the top three choices is going to be schwannoma, specifically vestibular schwannoma, it's going to account for about 80%, followed by meningioma, about 10%. Epidermoid is distal third. So top three, vestibular schwannoma, meningioma, and epidermoid cyst. Fortunately, on board exam and in real life, they all look quite different. So you should have no difficulty of telling them apart between the three most common entity on CPA cistern. In this case, you can see there's no enhancement, and also there's a lack of complete suppression of CSF. Otherwise, if this is exactly like CSF on all sequences, then you're looking at a potential arachnoid cyst. In real life, as you know, epidermoid cyst has the signature finding of restricted diffusion. So if you see that, then your differential diagnosis should be 100% this is epidermoid cyst. But even without diffusion, even without restricted diffusion or diffusion with a sequence that's been shown, you should be able to tell them based on the lack of suppression on flare and other sequences to pick the correct diagnosis, at least among these five possibilities. So let's look at other potential choices or other possibilities that does not work as well in this case. So let's look at first two, schwannoma, meningioma. So those two account for, as you know, both of them should show quite a bit of enhancement or avid enhancement. So if you think about CPA enhancing mass lesion as far as differential diagnosis go, your top two lesions should be schwannoma, as we mentioned earlier, versus meningioma, specifically vestibular schwannoma. Then other less common entity also quite possible you can think about would be other type of schwannoma, specifically involving the trigeminal nerve or the facial nerve. Ependymoma as well as metastasis are all possibility that if you do see an enhancing lesion. So for schwannoma, vestibular schwannoma, typically is a lesion that's either within the internal auditory canal, or in this case, you can see that you can have a sort of wider base, and sometimes that can cause a mass effect on the adjacent pons or in the middle cerebellar peduncle. But typically when it's this big, they tend to burst extending within deep within the fundus of the internal auditory canal, often filling the entire internal auditory canal, making this a comb-shaped appearance. So that's a typical appearance for vestibular schwannoma. Meningioma, on the other hand, they can also extend in, as in this biopsy-proven case, it can extend in deep within the fundus of the internal auditory canal, but that's not the dominant feature. Usually, when it gets to this point, the lesion is typically quite big. Normally, it does not extend in quite deep, but you should see this larger base within the CPA, and in this case, you can see the classic appearance of dural tail. So between those two lesions, you should not have any difficulty differentiating between meningioma versus schwannoma. When they are smaller, then it may be a little bit more challenging to try to tease them apart. Now, if you think about the last two lesions right here, the cystic lesions, so when I think about a CSF density on CT or CSF intensity on MRI, bright on T2 weighted sequence, the differential diagnosis, again, we talk about the distal third lesion should be epidermoid cyst, like in this case. However, other stuff that you can think about is arachnoid cyst, which should be very bright on T2 and dark or hypo-intense or hypo-dense on CT is just like CSF. With abscess, of course, you know it's bright on T2. However, you should see a rim enhancement as you know what abscess look like. Even though abscess does show quite a bit of restricted diffusion like epidermoid, but epidermoid should not enhance. So that's one easy way to tell them apart. Also, clinically, the patient should present quite different between active infection versus no infection. Neuroenteric cysts could be quite bright on T2. A lot of time though, they do not look exactly like CSF. Often, more than 50% of the time, they are actually bright on T1 weighted sequence. So I'm just going to throw neuroenteric cysts, which is an uncommon location, but does occur in those areas as well. So this is an example of arachnoid cyst. The key feature, of course, is that you should follow CSF in all sequences. So it should not enhance on T1 weighted sequence, or in this case, this is a flare. You should have a complete suppression of CSF, just like CSF anywhere, not like this dirty flare that you see on epidermoid, and it should not have restricted diffusion. So that's all for this case. Thank you for your attention. Good luck on your board exam.